This video is about cruise ship news. I can't wait to get into today's top cruise news stories. Here they are. Carnival Cruise threatens a $500 fine every time you do this one thing. We will get more into that in a minute. A University of Minnesota professor has a natural remedy for cruisers that suffer from motion sickness. Disney Cruises has revealed the name and theme of its newest ship. Royal Caribbean cancels another month of Labadee visits. And Princess Cruises is reuniting the cast of The Love Boat on the Enchanted Princess. Let's get into it. This is your source for cruise news from around the world. My name is Joseph. I'm going to be your host. Our top story. Tom Sofragan, a professor at the University of Minnesota, has recently commented on how to control and manage motion sickness on a cruise ship. He stated, "For reasons we still don't understand, ginger can help prevent motion sickness. Cruisers can benefit from eating a ginger cookie or sucking on ginger hard candy on their cruise." He also mentioned that the best way to combat motion sickness on a cruise is to reduce the amount of bodily stabilization that you require. This can be accomplished by sitting rather than standing, leaning back rather than sitting up, and closing your eyes. He also advised cruise passengers suffering from motion sickness to find an open deck, sit on a comfortable chair, close your eyes, put on some headphones and listen to music, and avoid looking at electronic devices. Well, I gotta say, I think this is great advice, and it's not like it's miserable advice. Ginger candy sounds great. Ginger cookies sound great. I do suffer a little bit from motion sickness on cruises. So next time I'm on a cruise and I start to feel the motion sickness coming on, I'm not going to put those things behind my ears because honestly, I think they make me feel worse. And I'm going to eat some ginger candy. I'm going to go up and find an open deck, put on some headphones, close my eyes, breathe in the ocean air, and just take it easy. Sounds good to me. Hey, I know we still need to talk about that one thing that you can do on a Carnival cruise that's going to get you fined $500 every time you do it. But first, let me tell you about this. Disney Cruise Line has revealed the name of its newest ship, the Disney Destiny, and the theme is going to be heroes and villains. The Disney Imagineering team was inspired by the duality of Disney movies, where light and darkness battle it out so that characters can rise to their purpose. On board, guests will encounter heroes and villains alike from stories such as The Lion King, Hercules, and 101 Dalmatians. The Destiny is scheduled to be delivered in 2025. Are you guys really excited about getting on the Disney Destiny when it arrives? My wife and I actually went on our first Disney cruise recently, and we did have a good time. But I got into a big confrontation with another person at one of the shows, and I have some not-so-great things to say about the Disney food. So if you're interested in controversial subjects like that, I made videos about the food and that confrontation that I had. I will have those linked in the description below. And here is just a quick update on anybody scheduled to go to Labadee on Royal Caribbean in the next month or so. Unfortunately, you're not going. Tensions are still high in Haiti, so in an abundance of caution, Royal Caribbean has decided to cancel Labadee visits for at least another month. They are restructuring itineraries for those affected. My wife and I have been to both of the Royal Caribbean private destinations, Coco Cay and Labadee, and we like Labadee bar none the best. They have a lot of fun stuff to do there. We actually joke about our day at Labadee as being one hot dog short of being a perfect day because we were so enthralled with swimming and snorkeling, the roller coaster that they have there, hiking around. We ended up not getting around to getting something to eat until a little bit too late. We went to the lunch shack. We were starving, and they were just closing down for the day, so we didn't get to eat anything at Labadee, but it is an awesome place. I hope that the Haitian people can find some peace, and we can all get back to going to Labadee. It is a fun time. So we're finally here. What is it that's going to get you a $500 fine every time you do it on your Carnival cruise? Well, the Party Line Carnival has sent out guidelines to its 2024 spring break cruisers, and they are not messing around. If you are caught smoking in a place where it is prohibited, like your room, like your balcony, you're going to get a $500 fine. Also, if you're caught throwing smoking paraphernalia overboard, you're going to get a $500 fine every time you do it. Other codes of conduct, like keeping quiet in the hallways, not using Bluetooth speakers, putting on earphones when you're listening to music or watching shows in public, not putting a towel down on the sunbather to reserve it for yourself for the entire day were also mentioned in the email that was sent out. I've got to tell you, there is no way that at my age, I'm going to take a cruise during March on Carnival or any other cruise line. I avoid spring break style celebrations like the plague. I guess it's just my age, but I don't see myself having any fun in that situation. Spring break is a young person's game. They like to break rules. They like to push boundaries. They like to get plastered all day long every day, listen to really, really loud, horrible music. It's funny how age changes your perspective and your interests. I have a hard time even remembering when I would have had fun doing those kind of things. But hey, it's a rite of passage for the kids. In our last story today, Princess Cruises is bringing back the cast of the popular TV show The Love Boat for a Love Boat-themed cruise. All of the major actors from the show will be back, except for one, for the 7-day, 5-port U.S.-Canadian excursion. Do you want to go on a Love Boat-themed cruise? Let me know in the comments. That's today's top stories from around the cruise industry on March 22nd, the year of our Lord 2024. Always remember, no matter which cruise line you choose or which location you choose for your next cruise, adventure awaits.